New Astronomers, Michael here, and thank you for tuning into my channel. And in this episode, I'm going to be going over the basics of using a Dobsonian telescope. First of all, the instructions in this video is aimed at new astronomers looking for some help just to get started, or to returning astronomers who may have forgotten how to use Dobsonian telescopes. And if you're of the latter, I think this is a good refresher video. Secondly, the instructions in this video pertains to telescopes without go-to mounts, meaning that there is no computer that will automatically slew the telescope to objects in the sky. This is only for basic mounts that are not motorized. A Dobsonian telescope is a Newtonian or a reflector telescope using an altazimuth mount called a Dobsonian. This was named after John Dobson, who is credited for popularizing the use of this style of mount, allowing for larger, compact, and more affordable telescopes. This style of mount uses the same two-axis mount, having the horizontal or azimuth axis and vertical or altitude axis. Many consumer-grade mounts use this same principle of a mount at the opposite end of the spectrum. The largest optical infrared observatory, the VLT, also uses telescopes mounted on altazimuth mounts. So I'd say you're in pretty good company. And so without further ado, here are the steps for using a Dobsonian telescope, starting with step one, which is to inspect and assemble the telescope. This tube here is called the optical tube assembly, which is made up of several components. Check your OTA for any missing or broken parts, including the primary mirror, which is located at the bottom of the tube, the secondary mirror, which is the smaller mirror mounted near the top of the OTA, the finder scope, the focuser tube, the base, make sure that it can swivel, the control knobs, make sure that they can turn and that they can lock the vertical axis, and your eyepieces. Step two, collimate the telescope. Collimation is the process of adjusting the primary and the secondary mirror using these knobs here or whatnot. However, some telescopes have fixed primary and secondary mirrors, so you can throw them in the back of your car for transport and the mirrors will stay in place. However, if your telescope is like this one and is sensitive to bumps, you may have to collimate the telescope frequently or before each use. I'm not going to cover the process of collimation in this video, but I did make a detailed video about it in a previous episode. So I'm just going to create a link in the description, or if this video supports it, I'll add a hot link right here. So just click this, watch the video, and come back. Step three, align your finder scope. Your finder scope gives you a low magnification view of the sky so that you can slew your telescope in the general direction of the object that you would like to observe. If it is properly aligned, you should be able to see that same object in your eyepiece. However, because the finder scope is independently mounted, it could get knocked out of alignment during transport. The basics of aligning your finder scope is to first locate a distant object like a light post and center that image in your lowest powered eyepiece's field of view. Then lock down your telescope and look through your finder scope and center that same object using the adjustment knobs on the finder scope's mount. I've actually made a detailed video of how to align your finder scope, so if you would like to watch that, please click right here, or I will also add a link in the description. Step four, observe through the finder scope. But first, make sure that the base is as level as possible. This is important because the horizontal axis will usually not have a locking mechanism. So if, for example, if you were to situate it in a slight tilt, like in a slope, the heaviest part of the telescope is going to tilt towards the bottom of that slope. Next, don't forget to remove the dust caps from the OTA and the finder scope. I'm sorry to state the obvious, but some of you might skip this step because it's so obvious. But if you're at a dark sky site, these dust caps are dark and they're kind of difficult to see. Or if you're like somebody I know, you know, who owns a collapsible Dobsonian for the first time observing, probably didn't realize that the bottom one also has a dust cap. Next, aim or slew the telescope in the general direction of the object that you want to observe. Rotate the telescope about its base horizontally, then loosen the adjustment knob, then tilt the telescope up or down about its altitude axis, looking through your finder scope to locate the object, and then lock it down. Remember that your finder scope is going to have a slightly greater magnification, so the distances between stars will be a little bit greater. Also, if you have a right angle finder scope, the images might be upside down. This particular one has a prism that automatically corrects them so that they appear right side up, as if you are looking through a straight through finder scope. Step 5 is to observe using your lowest powered eyepiece, and by power I mean magnification. Take a look at your eyepieces. If there is an X beside them, then choose the one with the lowest number. If not, they are probably in millimeters like the one I have here. In that case, choose the one with the highest number. In this case, it's going to be 24. Take that eyepiece and insert it into the focuser tube and lock it down. Then turn the focuser knob to sharpen the image. If you wear glasses like me, then you might find that you can't reach focus because your eye is too far away from the surface. If your eyepiece has a rubber shield around it like this, you can fold it away to get closer to the eyepiece. And if your finder scope is aligned, you're going to see the same object in the eyepiece. Enjoy. If you're just starting out, I recommend that you first practice observing bigger and brighter objects like the moon. And also keep in mind that the Earth rotates, so this causes objects in the field of view to drift away, and using a high magnification eyepiece will make objects drift away quicker. So I also recommend that you first use low magnification eyepieces, so that way you can observe longer by making fewer slew adjustments. Well, that about does it for this episode. If you have any questions or concerns, please let me know in the comments section. And also, I'd like to point out that the methods and procedures that I gave you in this video are just the way I like to do things. If you have your own ways, and if you have tips and tricks, please let us know in the comments section as well. I hope that this video was helpful to you, and if it was, please hit that like button, or better yet, hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you in the next video. As always, clear skies, and thanks for watching.